Good evening. It is my honor to welcome family, friends, faculty, and alumni to the 95th commencement ceremony at Avella High School. I stand here before you with the class of 2021 who have left their mark on the school and will continue by leaving an impact on this world. We went from taking our first steps into the elementary school in 2008 to taking our last steps in the high school hallways in 2021. After watching every class before us in prior commencements and saying we cannot wait for it to be our turn to graduate, it is finally upon us. Every single one of you are going to do amazing things, and I cannot wait to hear and see everything you have done in years to come. One thing about the class of 2021 is we are very competitive and do everything with dedication and love. You will not forget our class, not only because of the mural we dedicated to the high school in the cafeteria, but because of the tight-knitted class that we were and will continue to be. I want to thank everyone who has taken time out of their day to come and support our graduating class. Every single one of you have given us a strong foundation to be able to succeed in our future, and words cannot express how grateful we are for all of that. At this time, we will be opening tonight's commencement ceremony with the invocation. I ask you to please bow your heads. Heavenly Father, thank you for gathering all of us here together this evening for a celebration of our departure into your beautiful world. In all of this, please do not let us forget the countless blessings that follow in our footsteps. Please continue to protect and guide us on our new journeys in life, whether that is joining the workforce, going to college, or a trade school. Pave our roads with opportunities and inspire us to live each day with hope. Give us wisdom and help us to be able to use the insights and skills gained in our education in our pathways of life. Lord, be our light that we carry with us, even when we see no other way possible. Continue to walk beside us and guide us on each step of our journey. Watch over every graduate and help us to succeed in the plans you have destined for each and every one of us. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. At this time, the class of 2021 salutatorian, Haley Maseko.
One thousand three hundred and seventy-four days ago, when the class of 2021 walked through the West End doors, the countdown to graduation began. A journey for the class began that day, one that would be unpredictable and exciting. That journey was high school. Throughout our 13 years together, numerous students have joined and left the class. I am one of those students who have joined along the way. Since then, I have listened to multiple stories about the years that my peers have spent together, and I admit that I have worried about what I would say if ever given the opportunity to speak about my class's 13-year journey. I was unsure of how I could portray our journey to this point. I now realize that even though I didn't begin with my peers in kindergarten, that I am still a part of my class's journey. I came to Avella Elementary School in sixth grade. The atmosphere at the end of sixth grade was similar to how it is now. As our sixth grade graduation approached, we reminisced about the years spent together in elementary school, and we talked about how nervous and excited we were about the high school. Today, we are anxious and excited, thinking back on the memories of the years spent together and waiting in anticipation for college or the workforce. Some of the fond memories that have stayed with my class from elementary school are the checking accounts, the field trip to PNC Park, and the lemonade stand, just to name a few. The bonds that my classmates made throughout elementary school continued on throughout high school. Many say that these 1,374 days of high school will be some of the best days of our lives. So the question is, what did we do with our time? Some chose to focus on sports. They dedicated time to club and school sports and went on to be named all-conference and all-section players. The commitment of some of those athletes have earned them positions on college-level teams, enabling them to pursue both their career and athletic goals. Some of my classmates focus on academics. They join clubs, study for countless hours, and apply to their dream colleges. Many prepare themselves for the workforce. In addition to traditional secondary schooling, they attended Western Area Technology Career and Technology Center to train for their future professions. Others focused on the arts. They submitted work to the Scholastic Art and Writing Contest and won awards for their talents and efforts. Others traveled to band camp to perfect their performance, and they practiced their instruments daily. Though our paths were slightly different, my classmates and I made our journey together, and we still ended up in the same destination, graduation. Unfortunately, my class's time together was ripped away from us when our junior year came to an end without closure because of COVID. We hope that the pandemic will get better in time for our senior year, but I'm here to say that our senior year was far from normal. Many of us felt as though we were not prepared to face the major decisions that came along with being a senior. Despite this, we took the time we had left together and made the best of it. We enjoyed our last events together, such as dances and Senior Olympiad, and we shared in the excitement of planning our future endeavors. Throughout our journey, I have noticed that many students don't take the time to enjoy the 1,374 days of high school. However, as many of us now realize, time is precious and we never know what the next day will bring. So my reminder to everyone in the audience is to live life to the fullest. My message to the underclassmen in the audience is to make the most of your 4 years at Avella High School. While the class of 2021 reached their destination together, they did not make their journey from kindergarten to graduation alone. So, to the people who got us here, our teachers, the staff, our family, our coaches, and all of the influential figures that we encountered throughout our journey, we thank you. Though we may not say it enough, you are appreciated. You stood by us for the past 13 years and supported us through all of our endeavors. Fellow graduates, I encourage you to find someone who has been instrumental in your life and tell them thank you. The clock has stopped ticking and our 1,374 days are up. Just like that, our journey has ended. Those 1,374 days seem like a matter of seconds. This evening, my classmates and I ended our journey in the same place it started, walking through the West End doors for our final time as high schoolers, this time to put on our caps and gowns. I ask the class of 2021 to enjoy the final moments we have together. Think back on the wonderful times our classes shared, but happily await what is in store for you. Though this chapter of our lives is over, we have the rest of our lives to do amazing things. I leave you today with this quote from Harvey McKay. Time is free, but it's priceless. You can't own it, but you can use it. You can't keep it, but you can spend it. Once you've lost it, you can never get it back. My final request to my classmates is this: remember the importance of time as you continue on through the exciting journey of your life. And at this time, Jordan Chappell will read our class poem.
This is it, the night we've been waiting for, to say farewell with all this grandeur. You won't forget us, the class of 2021, but in case you do, we'll go one by one. Jaylene is going to Waynesburg to run cross country, while Aiden Riley is a huge Taylor Swift junkie. Elena is going to D1 at UT Martin for rifle, and Alyssa Jolie Sakel spends most of her time reading the Bible. Robbie West got his 100 wrestling wins, and who could forget Abby and Tyler, the Cerciello twins. JC should be proud of her prize-winning horses, and Will is going to culinary school to cook up main courses. Chris P. was crowned our homecoming king, and Lennon Herschel might take up acting. Sean Penrod is always asking one quick question, while Katie Kalila will pursue art as her profession. At the home football game, Ty's leg ended up broken. One day, Trisha wants to move somewhere close to the ocean. Caden and Chelsea are a class couple, and Blaze struts around, flaunting his hat and belt buckle. Dylan Chikowski likes to play guitar, while Gabe Bliss is always under par. Sam Bell cheered on the sidelines in the fall. Tanner Terensky was named the MVP of football. Trenton came back to graduate with our class, while Cassie Bademan rolls her eyes with such sass. Jordan Chappell will be tooting her tuba to country roads, while BJ Campbell goes to work writing codes. Don't let him fool you, Trent's Camaro's only a V6. David Fox can fix your computer at PC Whip. David Humensky likes to have his amp turned up to 11. Oso's is a place where you might find Michael Evans. Jeffrey Kramer quite possibly had the biggest case of senioritis. As a lawyer, Natasha Close will show no bias. McKenna got a full ride to Bethany, while at WNJ, Maddie will be studying chemistry. Haley's going to Happy Valley to be a Nittany Lions fan, and Donovan drives around in his Mini Cooper Countryman. Jesse Billiter likes Eminem, the rapper, not the candy. Brianna Stoltz artworks always looks fine and dandy. Abigail Best is headed off to Akron to study speech pathology. At a car meet, you can always find Logan Donnelly. You'll never guess Noah likes to listen to smooth jazz. Next fall, Chris Celia will be waving those WVU flags. Malia Carroll, she looked beautiful on this year's homecoming court. Football is Matthew Kidwell's favorite sport. And no, we did not forget about Autumn. She plans to go to CCAC for social work, which is pretty awesome. This year has brought obstacles, there is no doubt, but we're a tough senior class, so we figured things out. It's been 4 years, these last two the hardest. Thanks to COVID, it was also the longest. We did it, we made it, we're finally done. Thanks for the memories. We out, the class of 2021. At this time, the class of 2021 valedictorian and my best friend, Aiden Riley.
Hello and good evening. I am honored to be given this opportunity to deliver this speech. I want to begin by thanking the teachers, administration, school board, staff, and everyone else who worked behind the scenes, providing my classmates and I with the best education possible during our 13 years in the Avella School District. We have incredible teachers sitting here with us tonight. They have watched us grow since we entered kindergarten. Mrs. Minch challenged us with her infamous timed multiplication tests. Mrs. Cooper put up with us asking her for help with math questions every single day. Sorry, Mrs. Cooper. We competed fiercely when playing Wiki Wango in Mrs. Bredigan's biology class, and we sighed loudly when Mr. Deutsch instructed us to run the show one more time, knowing very well he did not mean one more time. Our teachers all watched us grow and become better students, and more importantly, better people. This relationship that we have formed with these incredible teachers is something that will never be forgotten. And we know they will always be there for us when we inevitably need them for guidance in the future. On behalf of all the seniors, I also want to thank our families for always being there for us and believing in us when we needed it most. From the first day of kindergarten, when our parents were quietly crying as they watched us walk onto the bus or into the elementary center, to tonight, as you watch us walk across the gym floor to receive our diplomas, you have guided us and watched us grow into young ladies and gentlemen. Without your support and encouragement, we would never be where we are now. Raising and educating us has truly been a team effort, and we are grateful for all of you. We made this journey together, and now it's time to leave the comforts of home and enter the big open world. My classmates and I have looked forward to this moment since kindergarten, and the excitement and anticipation has grown each year since then. Although this final year of high school has been less than ideal, it has taught us one very important life skill, perseverance. We should use what we've learned this year and apply it to the rest of our lives. We have spent our entire senior year living in a global pandemic, adapting to everything that was thrown in our way, even when we may not have understood or agreed with the sudden changes. Despite all of the challenges in both school, at home, and in our community that we've faced, we've persevered, learned some lessons, and hopefully made some changes for the better. Change is good. It makes us reevaluate our purpose and direction. Our lives are now about to change forever, and at times, life will not be easy. But after handling the obstacles of these past two school years, I think we've got this. Some of us will be heading straight into the workforce or the military, while others will be heading off to college or a trade school to further their education. But no matter what path we take, we must remember that we forge our own path, lighting the way into the future. Each of us has faced struggles, uncertainty, and sometimes even pain. But each of us has persevered to get here. We are talented, tenacious, and ambitious. We can each achieve greatness in whatever form that it may take. My wish for each of my classmates is for our future to become all that we want it to be. I hope that our dreams stay big, our worries stay small, and that we never need to carry more than we can hold. I hope that when we face uncertain times in the future, that we remain courageous and fearless. And no matter which path each of us chooses to take, remember that we are all human and we are on this journey together. To quote Taylor Swift, as Jordan said, no matter what happens in life, be good to people. Being good to people is a wonderful legacy to leave behind. So go forth, spread kindness and positivity, because graduation is a chance to start over, make changes, and become a better version of ourselves. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to introduce our superintendent, Mr. Cyril Walther.
Thanks, David. Today, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2021 on your many successes and accomplishments during your time at Avella and on your soon-to-be-realized milestone of high school graduation. I've had the privilege of knowing many of these students since preschool and one since birth. It has been an honor to be a part of their educational journey. I want to thank our school board, our administrators, and our teachers for their role in educating and supporting each of our students from elementary through high school. We have watched you grow and are excited to see who you will become in the future. Parents, we thank you for working with the school and your children. As your child moves beyond high school, I have confidence that together we prepared each of them to succeed with their future endeavors. These past 15 months have been difficult for everyone, and the COVID-19 pandemic has created hardships for all of us. Our seniors have definitely been impacted in all aspects of their lives, from wearing masks to school being conducted in person and remotely, depending on the community spread of the virus. Sporting events were played with very few spectators being allowed to attend. Only 6 students were able to sit at a lunch table with a large piece of plexiglass between them. Social gatherings were limited and social distancing was a must. I believe our seniors have responded well to the hardships that were presented to them due to this pandemic. They pushed forward and are all seated here today, meeting state and district requirements to graduate high school. Seniors, your future really is about the choices you make and the journey you are willing to take. I am sure we have all heard the adage that when one door closes, another is open. This is likely difficult to make sense of when the door closes. However, it really does create another opportunity if you are willing to keep pushing forward. Growing up, I met a boy during my 8th grade year at a church function. Let's call him Wyatt, because his name is Wyatt. We quickly became friends, and I found out that he was living with a foster family due to his father's incarceration. There were 7 children in Wyatt's family that had all been separated. Shortly after, Wyatt moved in with and became part of my family. He had a very good work ethic and wanted his own money, so he went to work for a company that washed trucks for UPS in Arden. He was 15 and would ride his bicycle to and from work in the evenings, making $3.85 an hour. The people working on a loading dock for UPS took notice of Wyatt's work ethic, and when he turned 18, offered him a job with UPS. Wyatt worked the dock loading trucks through college. He graduated with a degree in industrial engineering from the University of Pittsburgh. UPS then hired him as a mid-level manager, and Wyatt believed he had made it. All of his hard work had paid off. He went out and bought a couple new suits and a new purple Camaro, and it was a V8. A few years later, he married his high school sweetheart. Unfortunately, while the couple was expecting their first child, UPS cut their mid-level management positions. Wyatt was understandably upset, as he thought the rest of his life was planned out, and he could not believe his position was just eliminated. He had a child on the way and was in need of a job. His brother was working construction and helped secure him a position as a laborer for $8.50 an hour. Wyatt continued to work hard, and the owner took notice in the first couple of months, promoting him to project manager and giving him a raise. A year later, he was superintendent of construction. The construction company was building homes in Neville Wood, and a neighbor of a house being built, whose name was Stefan, saw Wyatt showing up to work every day and doing a good job. He would come over and talk daily and eventually asked if the company would finish his basement. The company did, and at the end of the job, Stefan asked Wyatt to come to work for his company. It was an audio design company that makes home entertainment systems, speakers for JBL, Kicker, and computer speakers for HP, Dell, Lenovo, and Samsung. Wyatt told him he was not sure he could do that type of work, but Stefan told him he could and that he would train him. Wyatt started out in operations, then went to sales, then director of sales accounts, managing director, and for the last 19 years has been the president of Xylox America. He has been able to travel all over the world and clocked over 206,000 air miles in 2019. My point is not to brag at what a success Wyatt has become, but to convey that the choices we make matter, that hard work matters, and that someone is always watching. Wyatt's life could have turned out much differently. He certainly has some strikes against him. However, he wanted more for his life than just being a statistic. Regardless of your occupation, always put forth your best effort. Enjoy the job and do not be afraid to walk or leap through the open door. If you're working hard, someone will notice, and that creates additional opportunities for you. We want you all to be successful, and success will look different for each of you. The pandemic has been a wake-up call for all of us. Fortunately, this wake-up call came in an early age for you and provided you with valuable lessons. Life is uncertain and there are no guarantees. You should not be content with just passing through. Whether your road leads to college, a trade school, the military, or the workforce, these decisions are not easy to make, and regardless of your personal road, there will be difficult times ahead. However, the road you choose in the near future does not have to define you. If you find your road is broken, remember that indecision steals many years for many people who wind up wishing they had just had the courage to leap, to take the next step, or mend their road. My hope for you is that you will remember fondly your time here at Avella. Remember the friendships you have made, remember the lessons you have learned, and remember the accomplishments you have achieved. Remember family and friends in the audience and the teachers that have supported you along the way. Take your knowledge and your life experiences and embrace each of the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. And remember, when one door closes, another door will open. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Please welcome to the podium the Avella Area School Board President, Mr. Corey McCon.
That's cute. But thank you for the introduction. The last year has definitely been a learning experience. Personally, I have learned that when I need to wear a mask, I do my best to avoid onions and garlic. I got some. As a board, district, and a community, we have learned many things as well. Some of those things are, one, we are grateful for all the dedicated staff we have here at Avella. They helped the past year go as smoothly as possible. Number two, we learned that more people attend our board meetings when they're held remotely. Three, we have learned that online learning may be a good choice for some kids, but for other kids, online learning was definitely not the best option. And most importantly, we have learned that we're very proud of the class of 2021 for everything that you have accomplished so far. To the class of 2021, when you look back on the last year here at Avella, I hope you realize that the bumps in the road and the disappointments have helped to make you a more well-rounded individual, and that you will be more successful in your future endeavors. Good luck in all that you do, and please continue to make us proud. Thank you.
At this time, Mrs. Cheryl Wright Brown, principal of Avella High School, will present the class for graduation. Let's go!
Good evening. Before I present the class of 2021 with their diplomas, I would like to recognize some of their achievements. The students seated in the first two rows are recognized for their academic excellence by earning a grade point average of 3.7 or higher. They are also wearing honor cords in recognition of this distinction. Please hold your applause until all seniors are recognized. Seniors, please stand as I say your name. Valedictorian, Aiden Riley. Salutatorian, Haley Maseko. David Fox. Cassandra Maidment, Noah Deviney, Gabe Liss, David Humensky, Katie Kalila, Abby Best, Kaden Unger, Donovan Avolio, Elena Walther, Chris Cilia, and Maddie Ansel. Congratulations. Thirteen members of the senior class have graduated from Western Area Career and Technology Center. These students have earned credentials and certifications that will provide them with educational and career opportunities after graduation. Once again, please hold your applause until all seniors are recognized. Blaze Allen, Electrical Occupations. Jesse Billiter, Emergency and Protective Services. Robert Campbell, Networking. Malia Carroll, Emergency and Protective Services. Abby Cerciello, Cosmetology. Trent DeGarmo, Heating, Ventilation, and Air Conditioning. Logan Donnelly, Auto Mechanics. Will Himmerich, Culinary Arts and Baking. Matthew Kidwell, Electrical Occupations. Sean Penrod, Culinary Arts and Baking. Autumn Roche, Cosmetology. Amber Ronowick, Emergency and Protective Services. JC Yoakum, Emergency and Protective Services. Congratulations. The class of 2021 has distinguished themselves also by being awarded over $450,000 in college scholarships over 4 years. 70% of your graduating class will be pursuing postgraduate education and training, while the remaining have obtained the knowledge and skills to enter the workforce after graduation. As your time in high school ends, I encourage each of you to focus on what you have learned and accomplished as a student at Avella High School and as a member of the Avella community. Congratulations. I will now present the class for graduation. Will the first row please rise? Valedictorian Aiden John Riley. Salutatorian Haley Gabrielle Maseko. David Joshua Fox. Cassandra K. Maidment. Noah John Deviney. Gabriel Jason Liss. David William Humensky. Kathleen Laura Kalila. Abigail Maylee Best. Caden Daniel Unger. Donovan Landon Avolio. Elena Marie Walther. Christopher Matthew Celia. Madeline Ann Elizabeth Ansel. Blaise Reginald Allen. Samantha Jean Bell. Chelsea Lynn Berdovich. Jesse Loretta Billiter. Trisha Lynn Brandenburg. Robert James Campbell III. Malia May Carroll. Abby Patricia Cerciello. Tyler Michael Cerciello. Jordan Alexandra Chapel. Natasha Jordan Close. McKenna Lynn Cowden. Trent D. DeGarmo. Trenton L. Tosh. Logan James Donnelly. Michael Robert Evans. Dylan Michael Jakowski. Lyndon Paul Herschel. William Kenneth Himmelrich. Ty Andrew Jaroski. Matthew Robert Kidwell. Jeffrey Paul Kramer, Jr. Jaylene Marie Mundorf. Sean Penrod. Christopher James Peterson. Autumn Paige Roche. Amber Nicole Ronowick. Alyssa Jolie Sakel. Brianna Michelle Stolz. Tanner Joseph Terinsky. Robert West. JC Ruth Yoakum. Seniors, will you please rise? Ladies and gentlemen, families and friends, it is my great honor to announce that these 46 seniors have successfully completed the requirements set forth by the Pennsylvania Department of Education as well as the Avella Board of Education to receive a high school diploma from the Avella Area School District. Will the students please move their tassels from the right to the left in recognition of moving from candidates to graduates? Congratulations. At the conclusion of the recessional, the members of the senior class would like a moment alone before celebrating with their family members and friends. Will the audience please rise for the playing of the alma mater?